Hello everyone, I'm back with a new topic known as the planning and organizing the housekeeping department. The planning is probably the executive housekeeper's most important management function. Without a proper planning, each day may present one problem after another. Since the housekeeping is responsible for cleaning and maintaining so many different areas of the hotel, the planning should be undertaken in a systematic manner in order to obtain the set objective. The step-by-step planning process may differ slightly from one hotel housekeeping department to another's, and different terminologies may be in use across companies. But essentially, the sub-processes and the tasks are the same. The housekeeping planning should be done on paper and needs to be properly documented. The question that arise at the beginning of the planning process lead to the formation of the basic planning document. Certain documents are essential, and they are: first, the area inventory list. Planning the work of the housekeeping department begins with creating an inventory list of all items within each area. An inventory list of an item within each area that will need housekeeping attention. Since most properties offered several different types of guest rooms, separate inventory list may be needed for the guest room type. When preparing the guest room area inventory list, it is a good idea to follow the same system that room attendant will use as their sequence of cleaning task, and that supervisor will use in the course of their inspection. For example, the area within the guest room may appear on an inventory list as they are found from right to left and from top to bottom around the room. Then we have the frequency schedule. The frequency schedule indicates how often items on inventory list are to be cleaned. Items that must be cleaned on a daily or weekly basis becomes a part of a routine cleaning cycle and are incorporated into standard work procedures. Other items which must be cleaned monthly or less frequently are inspected on a daily basis, but they become part of a spring cleaning program and are scheduled special cleaning projects. The frequency standard. The performance standard, they are required level of performances that establish the quality of work that must be done according to the expectations of the property. The key to consistency in service is the performance standard, which the executive housekeeper develops daily inspection and periodic performances. Evaluation should follow up with specific on-the-job coaching and retraining. This assures that all employees are consistently performing their task in the most efficient and effective manner. The performance standards are achieved when the cleaning methods are corrected, selected, and systematically followed. The ideal cleaning agents are used on the various surfaces involved. The correct piece of equipment are used on the various surfaces involved. Cleaning tasks are carried out at required frequencies. All the employees carry out their cleaning task in a consistent manner. Time and motion studies are periodically carried out in the department to obtain the best practices in the housekeeping department. The productivity standard. It determines the quantity of work to be done by the department employees. The productivity standard must be determined in order to staff the department within the limitation with the hotel operating budget plans. The housekeeping manager must know how long it should take a room attendant to perform the major cleaning task. Identified on the cleaning frequency schedules, such as guest room cleaning, once this information is known, productivity standards can be developed. Performance and productivity standards should carefully balanced. If the quality expectations are set too high, the quantity of work that could be done may be low. Every hotel must develop their own productivity standards, as There are several factors that influences these standards, which vary from one property to another. Some of the factors are the type and age of the property, the type of surfaces involved, and the degree and type of soiling. The accessibility of the work area from the service areas, the frequency of cleaning, the amount of traffic in the work areas, the type of cleaning supplies and equipment available, the functions of the work area, the quality of supervision and inspection, the expected standards of cleaning, the quality of employees. Now let's have a look on the example of productivity standards worksheet. Productivity standards. The time and motion study in the housekeeping operations. The extensive research in the form of time and motion studies to analyze the work method has helped the industry to find better and easier ways to carry out tasks and save time and energy. The time and motion studies for a task calculate how long it takes on an average to perform a certain task. This helps in calculating the staff level. To do a time and motion study, several staff members perform the same task, say the bed making. One by one, their movements are studied and clocked. The results are compared and an analysis is done as to how long it takes on an average to perform the task. The best practice derived from this study are then used by everyone, so that the resulting performance will be more standardized and more predictable. Any of the methods discussed below can be used by the executive housekeeper to do a time and motion study in her department. First is the pathway chart. This technique involves the study of the path covered by the worker in the undertaking and completion of a task. A floor plan of the work area is drawn to scale and fixed to a board on the wall. A long thread is spinned down at the starting point on the plane. The line of motion is marked using this thread. Whenever the worker turns, that point is marked with a pin and the thread wound around it. The length of the thread gives an idea of the distance traveled in the completion of the task. The time taken is also noted down. Various pathways are tried out to find the simplest and smallest route to finishing the task successfully. This is done to achieve the least exertion and minimal loss of energy and time. This technique helps the pinpoint all movements, then can be reduced or eliminated. Then we have the process chart. All the tasks in order to be completed requires a specific process or activity. In this technique, a close study of the process adopted is carried out and the flow of activity closely studied. A record of the time taken to finish the task is kept. All unnecessary movements and steps are listed down so as to be avoided in the final process adopted. Operation chart. This technique helps one track down all wasteful expenditure of time and energy in all the activity. The technique requires a detailed study of all the smaller activities making up a work per process. The movement of the two hands are studied in great detail and a fine analysis shows where in the delay are occurring. The micro motion film analysis. Using a timing device, every activity is filmed, then a detailed study especially of the finer movements of the hands and other parts of the body helps analysis the area where changes needs to be on or can be made to carry out the task with the least expenditures of the time and energy. In this, we use the cyclography. This is also a technique that uses the filming. Here a bulb is attached to the worker's body and whenever the body part moves, it highlights the bulb. The analysis of the complete film or the record of movement helps reveal how smooth and rhythmic the movements of the activity are. Thus, the workers may be guided to make the necessary changes. Chronocyclography. In this technique, a film of the activity is made with the small lights attached to the middle finger. The pattern or movement is filmed and finally analyzed to find out which movement were unnecessary or arithmetically and can be eliminated or improved upon. Standard operating manuals are the job procedures. A job procedure specifies the way in which a task is to be performed. The job procedures should be used during induction and training sessions and ought to be incorporated into the department's procedures. Manual updating job procedures is necessary as and when changes in equipment, cleaning materials and so on occurs. They are the most popularly called as the SOPs or standard operating procedures. They are also referred to as the work card. The SOP comprises the following information: the job to be done, equipments and materials required, procedures of work, the safety factors, the time required to do the job. The goal in establishing the SOP are as follows: to aid standardization, to help in training, to preserve the surfaces and materials, to ensure the completion of a task successfully, to effect a saving on cleaning equipments and agents, to prevent accidents, to help in training, to ensure the completion of task successfully. The job allocation and the work schedule. A work schedule is a document that lists the actual task to be carried out by an employee in a particular shift and the time frame in which to undertake each task. The document includes the following: the position of the employee, the area of operations, the time at which the employee has to perform the allotted task, timing of meals, breaks and any special jobs, the time for tidying equipment and closing up. The work schedule must be written in simple language and have a concise form. The number of schedules made for a given area is thus an indication of the number or staff required to clean that area on the particular day. The schedules should be handed over to the employees when they report for the work. The calculation of the staff strength. The calculation of staff strength is dependent upon the type of the hotel it is, the location of the hotel, tradition and customs of the locality, the size of the hotel in terms of number of rooms, the occupancy rate of the hotel, the management company policy, quantity of work to be done, the quality of work expected, that is the standard to be met, the time needed to be done to do the work, the frequency with which the work needs to be done, the time when the work area is available, the amount of traffic in the area. The staff strength of the housekeeping department mainly depends on the size and structure of the hotel, that is, whether it has a compact structure with clusters of rooms, the number of rooms per cluster or floor, the expanse of the public area and landscaped area, and so on. The general rule of thumb that aid in determining the staff strength in the housekeeping department makes a huge difference. One should have the executive housekeeper 1 for all 300 room property, assistant housekeeper 2, floor supervisor 1 per 60 room for the morning shift, 1 for the evening shift, 1 for the night shift, public area supervisor 1 for each shift, linen and uniform room supervisor 1, room attendant 1 per 16 rooms of the morning shift, 1 per 30 rooms for the evening shift, if turned down services provided. Linen and uniform room attendant 2. Houseman depends on the size of the public area and functions expected, but on an average 1 per 60 rooms. Desk attendant 1 per shift. Tailors and upholstery 2 may differ depending upon the size of the hotel. Horticulturist 1. The head gardener 1 per 20 horticulturist. Gardener 1 per 4,500 square feet of landscape area. Planning of the duty rosters, that means allotment of the jobs, hours of the duty, days for off of each member of the staff. The advantage are, it gives the exact number of the staff required to be on duty at any given occupancy, that the staff working hours are as per their employment contract, that regular off days are availed for enhancing the productivity. Knowledge of which employees are present on the premises in instances of the emergencies. Accuracy in attending and payroll reports. Step 1 in the steps in making a roster. Ascertaining the occupancy level and events expected in the hotel. Step 2. Ascertain the spread of duty hours to be scheduled in the duty rosters, whether 12 hours, 16 hours, or 24 hours. Step 3. Ascertaining the type of shift, split shift, break shift, rotating shift, etc. Step 4. Ascertaining the number of full-time and part-time staff on the payroll. Step 6. Incorporate the coffee breaks and mealtime allowance in the roster. Step 7. Ascertain that each employee gets a weekly off after 6 working days. Provide for the compensatory off. Schedule 1 relievers per 6 employees. Step 8. Ascertaining closed day and restricted holidays and any contingency planning that may be needed. Teamwork and leadership in housekeeping. The current trend in the housekeeping operation is to form teams to accomplish tasks rather than the scheduling employees on an individual basis. The three important determination of teamwork are leadership, building the right kind of groups of teams for better productivity and membership, which reflects the individual contributions people will make towards the team goal. A housekeeping team may consist of one supervisor and several, maybe 2 to 5 GRAs and one houseman. This team under the supervisor becomes the totally responsible for a particular section of guest room in the hotel. Cleaning performances, say, is then measured on a team basis rather than an individual basis. Team member rotates duty of bedroom and bathroom cleaning. Team cleaning is successful when ideas come from the employees themselves and they are given a free hand in their implementation. Promoting teamwork within each team requires this special effort. A teamwork checklist should be followed by the executive housekeeper to make it a successful. Reward teamwork by praising the team and giving them choice, assignments, raises, and promotions. Include teamwork as a criterion during the employee's performance appraisals. Rotate special assignments, allowing everyone an opportunity to shine as an individual occasionally. Consider ideas generating jointly by the team as well as the individual ideas. There are certain advantages of teamwork. A principal advantage to the manager is in being able to schedule a group of people as though they were one entity. Cooperation and workers' morale will be higher when they are part of a small unit rather than solitary individual in a large group of people. Team spirit will cause the entire group to excel in operation. GRE who excel in room cleaning helps the poorer performance on the team to improve the standards. Absenteeism and tardiness gets better resolved at the team level because one member being absent or late could have a negative effect on the entire team reputation. With increasing concern for safety and security, assigning two or more GRAs to clean a room could save expenses on liabilities and lawsuits. Mundane cleaning tasks may become fun when performed as a team. Fewer tools are needed, for example, one room attendant cart, one vacuum cleaner, and one hand candy can equip a team of two. Some heavier cleaning tasks are accomplished more easily and faster with two people, for example, moving beds, turning over heavy mattresses, making up a double bed, and so on. Bringing new employees up to the required standard becomes easier since they have buddies to coach them along the way. There are savings on labor cost since team workers complete work faster. Leadership. For teamwork in housekeeping to be successful, the department leader, that is the executive housekeeper, needs to be an inspiring role model as a team player. As well as an effective leader, the leader of a group can help to build its members into a well-knit team by sharing vision, goals, and strategies with them. Leadership is the capacity to frame plans that will succeed at the faculty to persuade others to carry them out in the face of difficulties. Leadership quality in a manager makes people look up to him or her for advice, feel motivated to work for and respect the manager, and be loyal to the manager. An executive housekeeper who can mobilize the trust and support of the staff achieves great height. An executive housekeeper who is a good leader will ensure the following activities. Draft a compelling vision. Communicate passionately. Get cooperation with others. Inspire and pull employees towards goal. Provide direction and momentum. Be assertive if necessary. Learn from others. Makes decision in line with the vision. Get a proper feedback. Command and not only demand respect and loyalty. Different leaders or the leadership styles may be used by the executive housekeeper. Some distinctly make people work by force or order. Others join the group and initiate activity. Still, others use persuasions, while some by their pleasant and endearing manner generate the enthusiasm for work and achieve goals in the best possible manner. An executive housekeeper who is an effective leader uses all these styles to different extent according to the nature of the decision to be made and as the situation demands. There are majorly four styles of leadership. One is the autocratic, which imposes own decisions with or without explanation to subordinates. Participative, where the decision made after prior consultations with subordinates. Democratic, that means the joint decision on the entire with the entire team which arrives at. And laissez-faire, when the decisions are taken by the different delegations. Most often, executive housekeeper tend to use the participative styles and depends upon more on communication, adopting a supportive attitude, and sharing needs, values, goals, and expectations with their staff. Employees, regardless of their level of education, are involved in the decision making. They became highly contributive to the successful decisions of the major consequences. They are then not only committed to the outcome of these decisions, they are involved in the success or failures of such decisions, are thereby motivated to continue their participations and personal growth. A self-assessment needs to be carried out by executive housekeepers to find out which style of leadership they adapt as their principal one
in actuality.
If you talk about the various kind of inventories, yes, planning of the inventories during the planning and organizing the housekeeping department is very much important. The executive housekeeper is responsible for two various types of inventories. One is the recycled inventories, which includes the linens, equipments, and some guest supplies like extra bed, iron, etc. The number of recycled items that must be on hand to ensure smooth operation is expressed as PAR. It refers to the standard number of items that must be on hand to support the daily routine of the housekeeping operations. The other is known as the non-recycled inventory. They include cleaning supplies, guest room supplies, guest amenities like toothbrush, hair conditioners, etc. They are used up during the routine activities of the housekeeping department. A purchasing ordering for non-recycled inventory items establish a PAR number based on two figures, that is the maximum and minimum quantities. The minimum quantity is the least amount at which reordering is done, taking into consideration the lead time. The maximum quantity is the amount ordered. Now, for this as well, we need to know how to determine the PAR level. The PAR level refers to the standard quantity of each inventory items that must be on hand to support daily routine housekeeping operations. The minimum quantity figures are established based on the rate of consumption of a particular inventory item over a certain period, for which can be calculated as minimum quantity is equals to the lead time quantity plus the safety stock level, where the lead time quantity is the number of purchase units that are used up between the time that a supply order is placed and the time that the order is received in hand. And safety stock level is the number of purchase units that must always be on hand in case of purchase units that must always be on hand in case of emergencies, damages, delays in delivery, and so on. So that the daily operations and functioning of the department are smooth even in emergency. The maximum inventory quantity, on the other hand, refers to the greatest number of purchase unit that should be in stock at any given point of time. Storage space, the cost of the item, and its shelf life are certain factor that must be kept in mind when establishing the maximum inventory level for a non-recycled inventory item. Most often, executive housekeepers tend to use the participative styles and depends upon more on the communication. Thank you so much.